It's freaking out. All that bang.
I wonder.
Yeah, I think he just needs to see the light. Not metaphorically. Alright, so we'll push him back in this direction and hopefully it flies up this way.
Yeah, exactly. Give us a second to explore. Like,
he's gotta be able to see there's an opening there and then like line himself up to fly through it, which
sprinkle some seeds on the ground and
I'll leave that door open for a second and let's leave the hallway.
Back and forth, after all. But the waves they make are super weak.
It's geeking out. I'm loving this.
This is Henry from Minute Physics.
Hi there.
What happens if an immovable object meets an unstoppable force? Is a popular question on the internet. Of course, relativity clearly tells us that there is no such thing as an immovable object. Here's why.
You make some of my favorite videos on YouTube, so.
You have a master's degree in theoretical physics, right?
I do, yes. This guy. Occasionally I make YouTube videos.
Occasionally. He makes videos where he draws about science stuff, but then he'll kind of augment them with visual effects.
I think I know exactly how you did that. Or at least I suspect. What do you think it is?
I feel like you have all those different arrows linked to each other, to the sun, in position, but lagged behind by a certain amount of time. So that it'll move, and then after like 0.12 seconds, it'll begin its animation and catch up. You have a way of making these really complex visual effects look so natural. When I was watching it, I found myself realizing that you were demonstrating the principles very, very well. Like, I felt myself understanding it way better just because you're able to show it happening the way it actually happens.
You wanna see if that bird is still there?
Oh, it's right there.
It's gonna need to sit there for hours until nighttime or something, and then like when the place is quiet, I'll try and leave somehow.
He just needs to fly to the ground, which he's not doing. Because there's too much activity.
Hopefully we just come in to find no bird rather than a dead bird. Or we might just have to invent a net gun. Option B, I guess. Carmichael, he would prefer us to shoot indoors, but Nick and I are rebels, and we're gonna go outside. That's right, Carmichael. Can't stop me.
You're not my mom. You don't tell me what to do.
Who's ready for an unboxing? All right, so here we go. Oh, what we got? Stream 900 portable SSD, 960 gigabytes. Wow, this is a 1 terabyte portable SSD. Oh, I think this has a USB-C connection. This is a nice looking hard drive. It's got rubber bumpers, rubber baby buggy bumpers. What we got here? Oh yeah, solid state drive. 256 gigabyte SD card. I've not had a card that big ever in my life. I have this weird thing about measuring the advancement of technology by whether or not I could eat it. I can now eat 256 gigabytes. It ain't no thing. At some point, hopefully I can eat like 10 terabytes. That's when I know I'll be really old. You know how many calories are in a gigabyte? A million. It's physics. Ask Ren.
How many calories are in a gigabyte?
48.
Sick. Dude, this is a 500 gigabyte hard drive. It's got little bumpers. Dude, all my data. Whatever. Is it like a frisbee? I expand flash drives, on the go mobile backup.
So this plugs into your phone.
I'm gonna take pictures on the highest quality settings. SanDisk, big thank you for sending us a box with all these cool things in it. And guys, we will tell you our impressions and what we think of this stuff as we use it in our studio. I hope it goes well. I'm sure it will.
What would you even call that? Nano watt?
It's like what I say in the video. It's like a quintillionth of a quadrillionth of a quadrillionth of a quadrillionth. This one is sponsored by folks that do distributed computing. You guys actually might be really good candidates for this. What it is there are people who do research and they need computational power. And instead of like just paying lots of money to rent out supercomputers, they have made like a really, really easy to install application that you can install on your own computer. And when you're not using your computer, you make your processor and your GPU available for them to do science research on. You're donating like your electricity bill and your like unused CPU time and GPU time.
Okay.
To scientific research.
That's really cool.
The way it works is like if a computer finds a signal, it's also checked by other computers. Generally, they will tell you like that your computer was involved in like finding this. They want to basically get people like you guys and everyone who's watching to install this software on your computer. It's called Boink. And then the particular project that I did this video on is called Einstein at Home. And it's searching for neutron stars, super fast spinning neutron stars in the gravitational wave data, but there's a whole bunch of other projects on Boink. You install this one Boink thing, and then you can sign up for different projects to allow it to go on
your computer. You can choose what research your computer does.
Yeah, so I have it set up to do this gravitational wave one, but there's a number of other things. Some of them are like biological, like genome searching or analysis, and there's other physics projects.
That's super cool.
You think that bird's still there? Or you think it escaped with that open door? I hope I don't have a dead bird to clean up in the corner of the room. I don't see it. Birdie? I think it's gone. Yay, the bird is smart and can figure it out after all. You wanna see what we got?
We got a little portable 500 gigabyte hard drive. I asked for the 2 terabyte one.
Well, we also got a 1 terabyte hard drive.
I'll make up for it.
Last but not least, this will make Carmichael the most happy.
It's
a 256 gigabyte.
90 by 95 read and write speed. This will be great for the next studio camera for the second channel.
That we'll eventually get one day.